Welcome to Hood War Stories. In this episode, I'll be discussing the war between the Venice Showline Crips and the Culver City Boys in Venice 13. The Venice Showline Crips are an African-American gang that were formed in 1972. They are located in the Oakwood neighborhood of Venice, California. The Oakwood neighborhood was originally labeled as Servant Zone by Venice founder Abbot Kinney and was one of the few places in Los Angeles where black people could live. Oakwood was made as a settlement area for black people as many moved there in the 1930s and the 1940s for work. The neighborhood was also known as the Ghetto by the Sea because it was so neglected by the city of Los Angeles. It also was named Ghost Town because they didn't have streetlights back in the day. In the 80s, the Showlines became involved in the narcotics business as crack cocaine hit the streets of LA. They are allies with the Schoolyard Crips and also the Harlem 30s. They beef it hard with the Playboy Gangsta Crips, Mansfield Gangsta Crips, Santa Monica 13, Culver City 13, and Venice 13. The Culver City Boys are a mainly Mexican-American gang that originated in the 1960s. By the early 1970s, the Mar Vista Gardens housing projects became their headquarters. Despite being Serenos, the Culver City Boys identified with the color red. In the 1980s and the 90s, the Culver City Boys were considered the largest gang on the West Side. Originally, the Showlines and the Culver City Boys shared the same housing project. Allegedly, the war between the two gangs occurred when the Culver City Boys claimed control of the projects and ran out the Showlines. Venice 13 is a Mexican-American gang also located in the Oakwood neighborhood of Venice, California. After the 405 freeway tore through predominantly Mexican-American communities in the late 50s, many migrated west into the Oakwood neighborhood. Venice 13 formed in the 1960s and also became heavily involved in the distribution of narcotics, with the Venice Boardwalk being prime market for selling to high-income residents who come from surrounding affluent areas. Their main rivals were traditionally Culver City 13 and Santa Monica 13. However, in the 1990s, they set aside their conflict to go against the Venice Showline Crips. A war kicked off in the fall of 1993 between the Showlines and Venice 13, believed to be over a drug-related dispute. From fall of 1993 until June of 1994, the war between the Showlines and Venice 13 left 17 people dead and 55 wounded. Most of this took place in a 1.1 square mile radius. In 1993, Mark Herrera, who was a Venice 13 member, was on the 500 block of Indiana Avenue when he was fatally stabbed by Deanna Calhoun, who was affiliated with the Showlines. Deanna was released after determining that she acted in self-defense. A few weeks later, Deanna was killed in a drive-by shooting. On November 7, 1993, Jeremy was walking home after getting off work on the 500 block of Brooks Avenue when a Venice 13 member spotted him and gunned him down. Jeremy LaShawn Peterson had no gang affiliation. On November 19, 1993, Broleo was on the 600 block of Indiana Avenue when Showline Crips rolled up and started letting off shots. Broleo Rodriguez died from multiple gunshot wounds. On November 25, 1993, on Thanksgiving Day, Culver City Boys firebombed two African-American homes. On December 12, 1993, Javon Clark was walking in Venice Boulevard when an 18-year-old Venice 13 member came through and gunned him down. Javon had no gang affiliation, and many believe he was targeted because of his race. Residents in the Oakwood neighborhood were terrified. Renetta, who was a mother of three who lives on Indiana Avenue, said it's scary. You can't even walk the streets in the daytime. After a deadly weekend in June 1994 that left two people dead and several others injured, both gangs decided to form a truce in exchange for a community center. The truce between Venice 13 and Showline held up, but another battle between the Showlines and the Culver City Boys took off. Their war kicked back off in February 1997 when Culver City Boys shot at an African-American who was visiting his mother in the Culver City housing project. On March 29, 1997, a 15-year-old African-American girl was critically wounded in a drive-by shooting in Oakwood. On March 30, 1997, Michelle Lewis was walking to a payphone on the 600 block of Brooks Avenue when a Culver City boy came by and gunned him down. On April 3, 1997, four Culver City boys were walking down Braddock Avenue when they were all struck by gunfire in a drive-by shooting. Allegedly, the Showlines did it. One of them died at the scene, and another was rushed to the hospital. On June 15, 2004, Michael, who was from Showlines, was on the 500 block of Brooks Avenue when three Culver City Boys came through and shot him in the head. George Saucedo of the Culver City Boys was ultimately convicted of first-degree murder. The Oakwood neighborhood today looks a lot different due to gentrification in the area. I'd like to thank you guys for watching. Please like, comment, and subscribe.